In this video, we're going to continue creating more buttons. We're specifically going to focus on these kind of rounded buttons. If you didn't see how we've gotten to where we are with class variance authority, you might be a little bit confused of what's going on. So I definitely recommend watching the previous video first. All right, so we want this rounded state. We want these rounded buttons. So if we go down, we can see what do those buttons look like. So we got circular buttons, and that is what we want. Actually, sorry, that's not quite right. That's these guys. We got these are the rounded secondary buttons. See, rounded primary. See, there's just so much repeat. In the previous way we had this, this is why class variance authority is really nice. So rounded full, that's really the only difference between this kind of a button and these buttons up here. So how do we do that? Well, we're gonna add another variant, essentially. We're going to call it rounded. This time there'll only be two different variants. So maybe you'd want this to be like, oh, rounded true or rounded false. Just stay away from that. You may want to add a third one. There's no reason to do booleans here. Just be very explicit about what you're doing, or a little explicit at least. So we're going to have rounded normal and then rounded full. Pretty easy, right? And like we said, this will be rounded full. Whenever you're rounded full, you'll be rounded full. That seems normal. But when you're normal, you actually aren't always going to be the same rounded. You'll be either rounded or rounded medium. So how do we solve for this? It seems really dependent on the size. You kind of have this covariance sort of thing going on. And the way you can do this is you can use compound variants, which is really cool. So compound variants takes an array, and the array can be a bunch of objects essentially. And these are just kind of all the rules for the compound variants. So these are rules of saying when this thing is true and this thing is true, or when the intent is primary and the size is medium, I want you to be this thing. So in our case, we're going to say when the size, and you can actually provide multiple sizes. So we can say when the size is extra small, or the size is small, and the rounded is normal, then I want the class name to be rounded. So that's pretty simple, right? It's really just like pretty simple logic of like, if this and this condition, if this, this, you know, or this, and this, or this, or this, then this. So we have the extra small in the small case, we're gonna have the medium, the large, and the extra large case, and that will be rounded, will be, oh wait, sorry, the rounded is normal. That might be a little bit confusing, but this is the variant name, this is the actual class name, right? Rounded is medium. And now we actually wanna get rid of these, because otherwise, basically we're just duplicating the number of class names that we have, which we don't want. There's just no reason to add all that extra stuff. Plus, we don't want rounded medium to be the case when the rounded should actually be full. So by default, the sizes, they don't know about your roundedness. They rely on the actual rounded attribute in combination with the size to figure it out. But in the case of rounded full, none of these will match, and the rounded full value or class name will be passed. So that's cool. All right, so nothing really, well, actually it did break on the left-hand side. So we need to figure out what's going on. And it's again, because we haven't actually passed in the rounded attribute. So we could pass in the rounded here. And if we pass in the rounded here, we should be good, except that we're not passing it up here. So I did say that these are partials, but because we didn't add a default, it's not going to know what to do. So we're going to say that the rounded by default is normal. There we go. Now we got all our roundedness back. Let's see what happens if we add a rounded as full. So actually we'll add these rounded buttons. So in this case, I want to map over the intents. It's basically the same thing here. But in this case, I'm going to pass in rounded as full, and we'll see what that looks like. Perfect. So we have all our rounded versions of the exact same buttons that we had before. So it's exactly what we wanted, which is great. Awesome. So that's really it for this video. Basically, that's the idea of what compound variants are. So it's a really powerful way to have this kind of combined logic, because otherwise CVA would just, it wouldn't be complete without this aspect, because that's how these sorts of variants play. They work together in different ways. In the next video, we're going to be tackling a much harder issue, which is the issue of these icon buttons and then these icon rounded buttons and whatnot. And so we'll be really heavily leaning on compound variants for that. See you in the next video.